Hey everybody, BrickLiver18 here today, and welcome back to another episode of Ask Brick. Ask Brick is my Q&A show here on YouTube, where you ask me questions down in the comments of any of my videos using the hashtag AskBrick. They can be questions about LEGO, my life, my opinions, whatever you want them to be, and then, of course, I answer them here on video. So today we've got lots of great questions, so I'm just going to jump right into them. Brickopoly Productions asked, Ask Brick, what's the most underrated set this year in your opinion? That's a good question, and I haven't really, because it's been like Corona time and all that crazy stuff, I haven't honestly bought or built many of these, this like 2020 set so far, just because, you know, when things happened in March and I had to go home for a few months, I didn't really buy any new Lego while I was there, I didn't really do any building or anything like that, but I have been recently buying a few more sets that were coming out that are back in stock now. And although I've only built one of the main, well, two, the White House and the Mickey Mouse sets from that big haul, I would say the Mickey Mouse set, like the Mickey and Minnie Mouse buildable figures, are some of the most underrated sets. Like, I think that's one of the most underrated sets of the year, just because building that first off was so much fun. I actually really enjoyed that build. There's incredible pieces in it. Just the overall design looks really good. Like when the especially the characters on the film, like the reels, the pieces they use for that, just like they're like transparent, but they're like opaque. I don't know. It's hard to explain them, but that was really cool. And I just really liked that set. And then when I build it up, I was like, wow, this is actually a really cool set to put on display. It fits great on my bookshelves. It looks incredible. So I think, like, at the end of the day, I think that's my most, you know, I would say that's the most underrated set of the year, just because when I looked at the picture at first, I was like, oh yeah, that looks pretty cool. But then when I built it, I was like, okay, wow, this is actually a really, really cool set. BlueBear2017 asks, how many sets do you have in your LEGO collection? And I think I have a pretty rough idea, but the best answer is I'm actually just going to head over to Brickset, which is the database I use to keep track of all my LEGO collection. I highly recommend you do that as well. It's a pretty great website. I haven't put any new the newer sets from my most recent haul in, so of course it's not going to be the most up to date. But according to Brickset, as of making this video on November 4th, 2020, I have 1,171 items in my LEGO collection. 1,103 are different. The size of my LEGO collection currently ranked is 1,838. I have a piece count for about 1,050 sets, and I own approximately 250,000 pieces. So yeah, that's pretty cool. And the retail value is about $22,000. So it's like roughly how many sets I have in my LEGO collection, about, you know, 1,171. However, that doesn't account for some of the more recent sets, maybe some minifigures or things that I haven't forgot to put in. And then of course the piece count doesn't account for any pick-a-brick cups, which I bought a lot of them. So I would, or like collections I amassed, I would say I definitely have over 300,000 parts for sure. But yeah, that's right now, that's the current status of my collection from Brickset.com. So definitely go check Brickset out. This is not an endorsement, but it's a really great website for that. The next question is from Cavendir Cow. I'm sorry if I said your name wrong. How big can the full LEGO City be? So that's actually a great question. Currently, the biggest my LEGO City can be is the two tables that it currently is. I actually just kind of reduced it a little. You'll see that in a video very, very soon. So like that's a sneak preview. But that's the biggest my city can be right now, just because, as I mentioned before, I love having a city. But for me, as like an AFOL, but like that doesn't do a lot of mock building because I do a lot of YouTube instead, the city for me is something that I like to have. It looks great. I like to, you know, play with it every once in a while and have fun with it. But for the most part, it is just an excuse, and it's just a place for me to store my LEGO city, my LEGO sets. You know, like I put vehicles in there, I put sets in there. Instead of having all those modulars and having them on a shelf, I put them in a city. But with that, because it's more of a display piece and is not something that I make a lot of videos on or something that I do quite regularly, for me it has to be a bit smaller because I build more sets and display more sets and make more YouTube videos. So of course my YouTube setup over here on this side of the studio, where it's just a dedicated studio, it has to be bigger obviously than the city setup, because I use this table and I use everything here way more frequently. So for me, my city can only be those two tables right now, just because I genuinely don't have enough space to expand it. Like when I first moved into this room, I had a huge city right in the center of the room, and I never used it. Like again, it's a display piece. I like to build it, make some modifications here and there, but I'm not like better Evans Bricks or other YouTubers who are so dedicated to their city. That's kind of what their channel focuses on. So my Lego city can't take up my whole room, just kind of like they have it. Like someday I'd love to be able to do that, but right now I can't do that. So I had to reduce the size of the city to make room for all the other things that I'm doing for my YouTube channel and for my Lego hobby that I do more frequently. So right now, the biggest the city can be is those two tables. But that's a good question. Lego Joe said, ask Brick, what do you think of the Disney sets and do you own any Disney sets? So that's really funny because I didn't read this question before I read the first questions from Brickopoly Productions. But yes, yes, Lego Joe, I do own Disney sets. So the currently some of the biggest Disney sets I have is I have all the Brickheads, I have the new Mickey and Minnie Mouse buildable characters, as well as I have the big Disney castle. And to be honest with you, I really love the Disney sets. I think they're pretty incredible. I especially love the Disney castle. I was so excited to be able to get that in my collection. That was the most expensive set I've ever had. I bought it all with the IP points, so that's kind of exciting for me. And as I said, the buildable characters, definitely a really underrated set, and overall I think they're really good. I love the Disney sets because I think they're great. I grew up watching Disney. It's got a special place in my heart, and I just think they're a lot of fun to build and really cool to display. So I would have to say I love the Disney sets. The next question here is also from Lego Joe. Ask Brick, what camera do you use? So that's a great question, Lego Joe, and I actually the main camera I use is a Canon T6i. That's what I'm filming on right now. But I actually made a whole Ask Brick episode just dedicated to what camera I use, because I use several different cameras when it comes to filming my YouTube videos. I use this camera for all my main reviews and videos like this. I use another smaller camera for any handheld videos like vlogs, city updates, things like that. And I actually use a third camera for speed builds and all that good stuff. So I'd recommend checking out that video. I'll put it in the cards or something like that so you can check that out. But it's a kind of complicated answer, but for the simple, just to give you a brief answer here right now, the camera I'm using for this video is the Canon T6i. Cookie said, ask Brick, do you ever think they will stop making Lego police stations or Lego police sets? No, Cookie, I really don't think they will. You know, police sets have always been kind of a staple in the Lego world. They've made them for years, from the Lego system days to the Lego town to now the Lego city. I think they're just going to continue making these Lego city sets, the Lego police sets, for years and years to come. I know there was definitely some controversy earlier this year about the Lego police station sets, and I heard they pulled them from shelves temporarily. But at the end of the day, like, police are still a very big part of our society. So I think that Lego is honestly still going to continue making those sets, just like I think they're going to continue making the fire sets, the ambulance sets and construction sets. Like, they're all pretty big parts of the Lego city aspect. Maybe they'll start reducing the amount they make them and not make them every year, every 2 years, with a brand new police station and everything like that. Like, we can only hope, because again, I want them to make more city sets for a Lego city. But for now, I would say that yeah, they're most likely still going to be making them, but I could be completely wrong. DZ Studios asks, have you ever been to an amusement park? Which ones and what are your favorite rides? So yeah, of course, I've been to several amusement parks. I'm trying to think of a few. Of course, Legoland was my favorite. I don't know if you even count that as an amusement park, but I went to the one in Billund, Denmark. If you haven't seen those videos, had a great time there. I didn't do too many of the rides. I mainly was like here for the Lego, but I did do a few rides, no roller coasters or anything, and I had a blast. I think Legoland's an incredible park. Definitely go check it out if you ever have the opportunity. You won't regret it. I've also been to Canada's Wonderland, which is a big one in Vaughan, Ontario, near Toronto. And it's fun. I like didn't love it because I don't love amusement parks, but it was a good time. I went on a couple of the roller coasters, but I didn't go on crazy ones because I wasn't about that. But I did go on my fair share, and I pushed my limit that day. And I've also been to Disney World, and you know, that's also an amusement park. There's lots of rides there, and it's a ton of fun. And I went to one, I think it's called La Ronde in Montreal, Quebec, which is, I think that's what it's called. But it's a really fun one as well. Great rides. Again, I went on a few rides. Didn't nearly push my limits as much as maybe I did at Canada's Wonderland, but I did definitely try and go on some of the rides. But for the most part, I don't love amusement parks. Neither does my family. My mom loves them. My dad, my sister, not a fan. So we don't really go to too many. Like, that's not what we used to do on family vacations. But I've definitely been to my fair share, and they're okay. I like the easy rides. I don't like crazy roller coasters. And I think we'll do one more question for today's episode. Just keep it kind of a shorter episode because there's lots going on. But Just Build It asked, ask Brick, what is the number one place you would like to visit after the Chima virus? That's a great question. And I think, I don't know. I was, you know, the Chima virus really screwed up my summer plans. I actually was going to have the opportunity to travel to several different provinces in Canada for my school for conferences. So I was really looking forward to that. And unfortunately, all of that was canceled. I was supposed to go to like British Columbia. I was supposed to go to Winnipeg. And unfortunately, that was all canceled. So that's really disappointing. But I don't think I'm going to go there anytime soon, but I think I would really love to go to Europe after the Chima virus has passed because I love Europe. I've only been once, got a few friends there that I haven't seen in a few years now, so I would love to go back and visit them, and hang out with them and see what's up with them. But yeah, I would say Europe is probably like, I don't know if I have a specific country in mind. I definitely would love to go to Italy again. London again was amazing. Now that I know what to expect in London, I definitely want to go back. I want to go to the Lego store. But yeah, I think Europe would have to be my number one choice. But I don't know when I'll get to go to that because as long as Canada has a 14-day isolation when you return, I will not be going anywhere because I cannot stay isolated for 14 days in my tiny apartment because I don't live here. So I wouldn't even get to come to my Lego room because I would be isolating. So, you know, as soon as they remove that 14-day isolation and I can come here, I could do that. But I can't imagine being cooped up for 14 days and not even getting to touch my Lego. But yeah, so hopefully, you know, after Chima virus, I'll get to go travel somewhere soon. I have the really big itch to travel, especially with online classes next semester. Like maybe I'll travel somewhere in Canada that I don't need to isolate because I really want to get out of the house and go try something cool. But all honestly, we'll have to see. Thank you, everybody, so much for all the questions today. I almost read another question off, but I remembered I said that the last one was going to be my last question. But anyway, thanks again so much for watching this episode. I really hope you enjoyed. Lots of great questions here, and they were a lot of fun to answer. So don't forget to leave your questions down in the comments below for next week's episode. I'll definitely make sure I get to them all and answer any questions, answer any of the burning questions that you might have. So thanks again for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and don't forget to have a great day.